Good morning, children. Let us begin with Standard 4 EVS, Chapter 14, Baswa's Farm, Part 1. So, in this chapter, we will learn about farming and growing the crop of onion. So, let us begin. I am Baswa. My father is a farmer. We live in Belwanika village in Karnataka. It is the month of July. Like every year, Appa, my father, is preparing the field to sow the onion crop. There are so many things to be done at this time. To help him, I too go to the field with Appa. In the last few days, Appa has been using the kunti, an iron rod, to dig the soil, loosen it and make it soft. So we have a boy called Baswa who is introducing his father, and he's saying that his father is a farmer and they live in Karnataka in Belwanika village. Now, according to him, it is the month of July. And the month of July is most favorable to grow the onion crop. So Baswa says that his father is preparing the field. He is preparing the soil so that they can sow the seeds of onion so that it can grow. It is the best month for the onion to grow. So he says there are many things that we have to do before sowing the seeds. So his appa, he's working in the field and he has a lot of work. He has to take the kunti. It is a iron rod with the help of that rod, he digs the soil. He loosens the soil. He makes it soft. And he has a lot of work. So Baswa says that he also helps his father in preparing the field so that they can sow the onion crop. So as you can see, this is called the kunti. With the help, this is a wooden rod and that iron slope that you can see, it is made of iron. It is very sharp and it is used for digging the soil so that the soil is dug and it becomes loose and soft, and so that they can sow the seeds in the soil. Sowing the seeds. This year also, my father will sow onion seeds in the field. The bullocks will pull the kurigi and Appa will walk behind them. So again, it is the month of July, as Baswa said, and in this year also, in the month of July, they are going to sow the onion seeds. And you can see his father and there are two bullocks, and behind that bullock there is a kurigi with the help of which he is plowing the field and is preparing the field for the seeds to be sown. Sprinkling the seeds. I would also like to do this just like my appa. But appa says that it is necessary to drop the right amount of seeds at a regular distance. It is not so easy to do. He says that I may drop too many seeds at one place. I must wait till I am a little older to be able to do this properly. So as Baswa said that his father, Appa, he walks behind the bullock, which the bullocks are pulling the kurigi, and he is walking behind them, and at equal place, he is sowing the seeds in the soil. So when Baswa sees his father doing all this, even he feels like he should also sow the seeds into the soil. He feels that it is very easy. But according to his father says that this is not a very easy work. Only a perfect farmer, he knows that how many seeds have to be dropped into the soil and at what distance how many seeds have to be dropped. Then only that crop will grow proper. And to know all this, Baswa is still young. So when he grows a little older, he will understand that how he has to do, and he will be able to do this work very properly, because even the crops need proper place to grow. Each crop, there should be a proper distance. Only the farmer knows properly. You or I cannot do all this work. We feel it is easy, but this job is also very difficult. Earlier, the farmers used to use bullocks, and they used to attach that kurigi at the back, and they used to walk behind, and they used to plow the field. But nowadays, as modern techniques are used, tractors are attached with this kurigi, and they can be drove. Those tractors can be drove in the farms and fields, huge ones, and the kurigi is attached at the back, and the farm is plowed. And the kurigi, with the help of that kurigi, they plow the field and prepare it for the sowing of the seeds. So these are all modern techniques. The sprouts appear. It is now 20 days since the seeds were sown. The onion plant has started to sprout. Along with onion plants, weeds have also come up. So now you can see 20 days have passed, and after sowing the seeds of 20 days, you can see small plants have started growing up. And along with that onion plant, there are other plants also which are growing that we call the weeds. These weeds are the unwanted plants which are growing along with the onion plant. Now, the seeds of these unwanted plants are not sown by us. They automatically grow. So, weeds have started growing in the farm with the onion crops. Weeds grow in fields and gardens without being planted. Appa says that we must remove the weeds so that they do not take up all the water and fertilizers. If there are too many weeds, then the onion plant will not be healthy. Amma, uncle and I, we all help Appa to take out the weeds. So as I just said, that these weeds, they do not need to be sown. The seeds do not need to be sown in the soil. They automatically grow. So what his father says, Baswa's Appa says, that these weeds have to be removed. Why they need to be removed? Because they grow next to the onion plant, and whatever water, whatever fertilizers we are putting for the onion plant to grow healthy, all those fertilizers and water is also utilized by these unwanted weeds, unwanted plants. And we don't want these weeds to grow healthy. We want our onion crop to be more healthier than them. So if we want our onion crops to be healthy, we need to remove these weeds as soon as they grow. So Baswa's mother, Amma, uncle and he himself, they all help his father to remove this unwanted weeds from the farm. Growing plants. I am happy to see the plants growing. They are tall enough to reach my knees. The leaves have started turning yellow and drying up. This means that the onions are ready to be taken out. So now you can see Baswa is in his onion farm, and he says that he is very happy to see that the onion plant is now ready. How do they know that this onion plant is ready for cutting and harvesting? He says that the leaves which grow, they turn little yellowish and they start drying up, and till it reaches to a certain height, till his knees, he says that they are ready when they are dry and yellow. So he says that now this is the right time that the onion is ready and they need to cut it out and take them out. So here you can see the onion grown plant. Right from the seed, the way it grows and where the onion, then it rises up above the soil until it is height, till the knee height. And the leaves have grown nice and big, and then they turn yellow and they dry up a little, and they understand that the farmer knows that his onion crop is ready to be cut. Everyone at home will have to work to take the onions out. It is important that this should be done at the right time. If we are late, the onions will rot in the ground itself and all our hard work will be wasted. Baswa helps his father in the field. Do you help the elders in your family in their work? What do you help with? So now what does Baswa say? That everyone from the family, so who are all in his family, his uncle, his mother, and he himself, they all are working in the farm to remove the onion crop. Now it is very important, the right time to recognize that when the onion has completely grown and they need to remove that crop. If they do this little later on, if they don't do it on the right time and it is done a little late, then the onions, they start rotting in the ground. And all the hard work that around, hard work of 1 month, that they have worked hard on this growing of the crop, raking out the weeds and watering and putting fertilizers, all that hard work will be wasted. So even Baswa helps his father in the field. Now children, we all help our elders in some or the other work. The boys might help their parents by going and bringing certain vegetables from the market or going and buying something from the shops. And even the girls help their mothers in the house. So we, in some or the other way, we help our parents in doing work, as how Baswa is helping his father in the farm. Everyone at home is happy. This time the onions are big and healthy. Amma and auntie use the iligi to cut the dried leaves from the top of the onions. The iligi is sharp and you have to be careful not to cut your fingers. Appa and uncle fill the sacks with onions. Appa will take them in a truck to sell in the big market. Now, after all the crop is harvested from the farm, from the fields, they take it into their homes, and then Baswa's mother and aunt, they cut all the green leaves which have grown, as we saw. They cut it with the help of an instrument called iligi. Now, this instrument is very sharp. You have to be careful that you don't cut your fingers. And after they separate all those leaves from the onion, then uncle and Baswa's father, they fill all that onion in sacks, and then they will take it into the trucks and go to the big market to sell the onion. So here in this picture, you can see Baswa's mother and aunt, they are cutting the leaves and separating it from the onion using the instrument called iligi. And his father and uncle are filling all the onions in the sack so that they can sell it in the market. And this is the instrument called iligi. It is used for cutting. You can see the it is very sharp, and we have to be very careful while cutting so that you don't cut your finger. Now, given here are pictures of some implements. Implements means certain tools used by Baswa's family. Write the name of the implements. Also write what these are called in your area and for what work are they used. So the first instrument that we use, the implement that is showed is, and the name of this in the chapter is Kurigi. And in our area, it is called Kudal, and the work that it is used for plowing. The second picture is, we just saw, correct, it is the Khunti. In this chapter, it is called Khunti. And even in our area, it is called Khunti, and it is used for digging. It is used for digging the soil. And this implement is the iligi. I just showed you the picture. And in our area, it is called the sickle. certain sickles are we can hold it in the hand, but this we have to hold it in the foot and cut it. And the work is you use for cutting vegetables. Certain people in certain families, they use such an instrument to cut vegetables. Now many steps are needed to grow crops. Look at the pictures and mark them in the correct order. So as we read the lesson, we saw many pictures and there are many steps of growing crops. So now we have to give numbers to these pictures. So the fourth picture, you can see that Baswa, with the help of a Kunti, he is digging the soil. So that will be your first step. Then the third picture, he's sowing the seeds. So that is your second. Then the second picture, that lady is removing the extra weeds grown in the soil. So that is your third step. The fourth step is that she is removing the onion crop from the soil. She is removing the onion. That will be your fourth. Your fifth will be the fifth picture itself, that Baswa is cutting all the crops and he is removing the onion plant. And the last will, the sixth picture will be the sixth step, that he collects them in the sacks. So dear children, I hope you have understood this lesson of Baswa's farm. So now the homework for this lesson is that you need to read this chapter at least once or twice. So thank you and have a very nice day.